see how long the claws are. Bam. Suave. Russ Pitts here on location of the new movie X-Men Origins Wolverine. I'm going to be talking about Raven Software's X-Men Origins Wolverine video game. Talk to the guys behind the game, give you some insights into what makes it Wolverine-ish.
You're not from around here, are you?
What gave me away?
Oh, yeah, from out of town, too. You know where I can get a good Swedish massage? The full deal.
Well, well, well. Look what the cat dragged in.
Look at the cat dragged. Oh, you're talking to me? Yeah. Yeah, you're busting my chops. I know. I had the swine flu. I know. I'm looking a little rough. Need to press my jacket, but thanks for noticing. Nice shirt. Holy shit. Scared the crap out of me.
Why?
Well, I mean, busting through the door like that, going, rah! I mean, what the hell? Scare anybody. What?
Why?
Talking to him or to me? Him? Me? Me?
You don't call. You don't write.
Guys, whatever this is, take it outside.
Oh, are you guys together? Because I know it's that kind of bar. Yeah, f*** that. I'm out of here.
In this case, it was just finished with Marvel Ultimate Alliance. We were finishing that up, and some of the people were available to work on other stuff. It's like, hey, you know, let's make this Wolverine stuff. Let's do a couple of these things. And, you know, a small group of people made, like, our first demo, which people looked at Activision and everything, and they were like, looked at, and they're like, yeah, this is totally something we want to do. Like, this is this game. This feels right. You guys are delivering the authentic Wolverine experience.
We have his DNA. Terminate him.
We kind of sat down at the proverbial whiteboard and went through, you know, what are the things that make Wolverine Wolverine? And one of them was like the way he can fight razor sharp claws. In other games that we saw, you know, his claws wouldn't do damage to people and it really didn't make a lot of sense to us. These are like teen rated games, and for whatever reason, they couldn't actually show what claws would do to someone. So for us, it was, we want to make it so you can fight like Wolverine, make an authentic experience that's true to the character. That was like number one importance. The other thing we wanted to nail was the regeneration. Wolverine's mutant ability is regeneration. We wanted to make sure that we could show that in the game. So instead of like Wolverine getting shot or cut and you not seeing it on his body, but you just see a health meter go down or go back up when he's healing, we wanted to make it so that the user actually sees it on the character. So we have actually four layers, a clothing layer, a skin layer, a muscle layer, and a skeletal layer. Wolverine takes cuts that go all the way as deep as to the bone. And you can see them in the game. They bleed, the blood runs down from them, they heal up in real time, and they bruise over. And that was a huge effort in the very beginning of the project, but something like ultimately we feel like we really nailed. And like the last thing we want to do is make sure we're delivering on the character. That's the character, you know, it can be seen with combat, it can be seen with regeneration, but even in like the cinematics, we wanted to make sure that we're delivering on who we think Wolverine is a character. It's like just the total badass, you know, and everything kind of goes back to that point.
At my command.
We were able to take, you know, the pieces in the movie and put them in the game and tell that story, but also show kind of like our own story, our own background on Wolverine before he became part of the X-Men. So it was really important to us to be able to like include all those elements, you know, and make sure that we're not just getting like a 5-hour experience. As far as like getting Hugh on board, he was just a great partner. He was just a total professional, and we did voiceover with him, and everybody that got to work with him absolutely loved him. You know, they came back with all these great stories of how he tried to show him parts of the movie and like producers are trying to shut him down. So, and when it comes down to it, we weren't out to make a bloody game, like an M-rated game. We were out to deliver the Wolverine experience. And wherever that fell, when the ESRB finally looked at it, that's the rating that we got. First of all, fans are going to think it's a movie game and it's going to suck. Everybody kind of is down on movie games. And, you know, for whatever reasons, games do come out that maybe had to be rushed a little bit, or the quality isn't as high as some other games that come out. And you know, I think people are going to be surprised by, one, the quality level of this game, but two, like, the combat, the kind of combat that you're seeing in this game, and the regeneration on the character. I think fans are going to just go overboard with the stuff that we've added to the game, the different levels that we've added to the game, plus, you know, people that see the movie will dig playing the parts of the movie maybe they recognize, and levels they recognize from, like, comic lore. So it's, like, really touching on a lot of different, you know, bases of fans there. So there's a lot of things to be excited about. And it doesn't suck.